One of the most important topics when developing your application is how to search for the information you need. The PyWeb API has the option to search on attributes, event frames, elements, and other objects based on a number of search criteria natively. Searching and filtering the objects being returned is critical to the performance of the application, as we never want to request more information from the service than is necessary for our application, as doing so will negatively affect the performance. You can search on most controllers in the PyWeb API. These searches take on the form https://your machine name/PyWeb API/the controller name. This is going to be whatever you want to search for, event frames, elements. Then /search, a question mark, database ID equal to the actual database ID that you'll be searching on, an ampersand, query, an equal sign, and then your search criteria. The search criteria is available to be viewed on the help file documentation. This may seem overwhelming at first, and will take some time to get familiar with the range of search options available to you, though searching in the PyWeb API holds a lot of power once the syntax is grasped. So let's start with a simple example to get our feet wet and work through some of the syntax together. Let's say we're looking for event frames in our database. To do this, we'll need to set up our URL to be the base URL, slash, event frames, another slash, and then the keyword search. Next, we'll need to know the AF database's web ID that we'll be searching under, followed by another slash. Let's get our database ID using comb quickly. Next, we'll need some search criteria. Let's say we only want to find event frames based on a particular event frame template. If we take a look at the documentation for the search query syntax, we see that we have the option of specifying a template. To do this, we'll need the keyword template, followed by some equal operator, and then a string value. Let's take a quick look at the equal operator in the syntax help page. It looks like from here that in order to do an equivalency comparison, we'll need either a colon or a colon and an equal sign. For the string value, this is what you would expect: a string of characters either in single or double quotes, or if there are no spaces, then you can just type the string itself. Let's use this information to build out our search query. Remember that we're going to need to use an ampersand to add our second URL parameter, followed by query equals, and then the search query criteria. For this example, I already have an event frame template set up called boiler fuel over limit. Let's execute this request. So dropped an A in database here. If we take a look at the response, we see that we have event frames based off of this particular template. We can search based on a number of different criteria as seen in the documentation, such as start and end times that the event frames need to be contained within, or whether or not the event frame is in progress even. If we want to narrow this further, we could search on name or start time, but let's do something a little more interesting. Let's search on the value of an attribute in the event frame for our search criteria. If you'll notice in the documentation, one of our query operations possible is based on attribute value filter. According to the documentation, an attribute value filter consists of an attribute path, followed by some sort of operator, and then a string value. According to the documentation, we define an attribute path as a vertical bar, followed by the name of the attribute. In this case, since we're using operator instead of equal operator, we have the option of using both what is contained in the equals operator, as well as these other possible values, not equals, less than, greater than or equal to, etc. In my case, I've been tracking the average, maximum, and final fuel flow rates in these event frames. I'm going to be filtering on the final fuel flow rate, and I'll filter out anything that has a value less than 2.5 at the end of the event frame. In order to add the attribute value filter, I'll need to add a space, and we'll URL encode that off the bat with %20. Then I'll be adding the attribute filter name. Since my attribute value name has spaces in it that I've already encoded using the %20, we'll also need to wrap this in single quotes. While single quotes are also a URL special character, these can be encoded using %27. If we execute this request, we see that we narrowed our list even further. We've taken a brief look at the search capabilities in the PyWeb API, as well as how to interpret some of the documentation for it as well. We made a simple request using a single filter criterion for a template, and we made a more complex multi-criteria request using attribute value to filter as well. We've only just scratched the surface of the complexity of the search functionality in the core PyWeb API, but this should be sufficient for you to begin using the filter criterion to optimize your applications to retrieve only the necessary information.